Section 4, the cumulative vision of faith. Hebrews 11:8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out to a place which he could receive after for an inheritance, obeyed. And he went out, not knowing where he went. By faith, he sojourned in the land of promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise, for he looked for a city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is God. This is giving a little more detail because the promise is being elaborated. There's going to be an inheritance for God's people. Ultimately, he's talking about the new city, New Jerusalem. That vision caused him to leave Babel. It is said that his father Terah was a priest, thus a high official in Nimrod's court. Abraham would have had plenty of opportunity to build a place for himself in the greatest empire of the world at that time. He would have secured a destiny for himself there, or at least a good living. Instead, he exited and eventually ended up dwelling in tabernacles. They were tents, but I like how the KJV calls them tabernacles. The tabernacles are a contrast to Babel. They are an anti-type of Babel. Babel is a huge tower, and in contrast, you have these little tents, these little tabernacles. However, these tabernacles are a prefigure of the tabernacle in which the God of Shem would dwell among his people, according to Genesis 9:27. Abraham's tent in which he dwelt became a tabernacle. That was also a meeting place. The Lord came, met with him there, and dined with him. Abraham made a meal consisting of a fatted calf and 3 measures of meal, which prefigures the fellowship offering in Leviticus, Genesis 18:6 and Leviticus 2:1 16. Abraham was acting as a priest before the Lord at the tabernacle, whether he knew it or not. All of this is an antitype to Babel. Abraham lived in tents because he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker is God. In Hebrews 11, we see more and more detail concerning what faith contains. Faith believes in the blood, Abel. Faith believes in the judgment to come. Faith believes in an escape for God's people, Enoch and Noah. Faith also builds the house of God, represented by the ark and the tabernacles of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Faith sees into the future, into the new city Jerusalem, or the new heavens and the new earth in which righteousness dwells. We see that faith is a vision. That kind of vision separates you from the world spontaneously. Practically, it separated them from the world so that they could not live in Babel. But we live in mystery Babylon today, and practically, we cannot physically separate ourselves. However, if we are full of the vision of faith, we will want nothing to do with Babylon. We really do not. We live a quiet life of abiding in the Lord and being content. In contrast, the world goes on in their ambition, building and pursuing all their aims because this is all they have. Whereas we look for a city whose builder is not man, but God himself. So there's nothing for us to do but wait. We are not building in the sense that the world builds, but we are abiding as the world passes away. And as we abide, we face not Babel, but Christ. Hebrews 11:11. Through faith also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed, and was delivered of a child because she was past age, because she judged him faithful who had promised. Therefore sprang there, even of one, and him as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky in the multitude, and the sand which is as the seashore, innumerable. Abraham's faith concerned the land where he sojourned. It also concerned the seed, which is ultimately Christ. In Christ, we who have been baptized into him have also become Abraham's seed. We are the ones in whom Christ is multiplied in the church as the stars in the heavens, whereas the earthly descendants of Abraham will be like the sand of the seashore.